Hello YouTube, I'm David with the David West Channel. I want to encourage you to practice fire techniques at least every now and again. It doesn't take long for especially these three techniques I'm about to show you. Let's do a little keychain ferro rod, pine needles, and we'll use my Stanley 10-049 to scrape that ferro rod. I don't know why they call it a keychain ferro rod, because it would be more aptly named a key ring ferro rod, but that's just the way the company advertises it. So and I know you're getting tired of hearing me describe this, but you just want to process them until they'll hold the shape of a ball. Then you put them down on the sawhorse, make a little depression right in the center of them. That depression will catch the sparks and will make some walls for those flames to climb up. So these pine needles are particularly thick, so you might have to buff them out for 30 seconds or so. But at some point, they'll be like I like them, in a shape like that. This is a bayite keychain ferro rod. It is 3 1/8 inches long by 5/16 in diameter. All right. Let me show you some flint and steel, one of my favorites. I kind of like these smaller flakes. Here's a good flake. And we'll get a piece of denim char cloth out of my peanut can. And you can see the bias running this way. And we'll tear it across the bias and it will expose all of those threads. Lay both thready ends up on top of one another, like 1/16 of an inch behind that sharp edge. And use my handy dandy steel that I made out of a Nicholson file. But first, we gotta get some tinder ready. Sticks. I think I got them all. It's about 1/16 of an inch behind that sharp edge. It's hard to see anything out in this bright sun. But we have ignition. All these techniques are a lot of fun to practice, as you can see. All right, let's go ahead and get set up now for the fire roll. I tried twice with the mostly char out of that stove and failed on the fire roll. So let's just go back to ashes that we know will work. This is 3 inches of cotton. We lay it down. So that we have like 6 inches of cotton right there. About a quarter teaspoon of ashes, some ashes on the bottom board. That should ignite no problem. We've been doing it like this for years. But this is another advantage to getting out here and practicing, finding what your limitations are, making those adjustments, kind of figuring out what it, how things are supposed to react, and knowing when they're, you know, something's a little off. Now let's see if we can get ignition. This is my third try. And I'm having to hold the sawhorse with my knee so it doesn't wobble so much. And if you don't see smoke, go back and roll it some more. All right, y'all, do me a favor. Before you leave my channel, please subscribe, hit the notification bell, and in that drop-down list, select all. And do give the video a like. Appreciate you joining me on this one wheel. Catch you on the next one. These are some resilient pine needles.